For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us be glad and rejoice in it. America has forgotten God. America has forgotten to thank God but one time in a year. And we don't even thank God on that time. We watch and we pig out on the television. We don't give God his proper place. For God so loved the world that he gave an ultimate sacrifice. True love is sacrificial, that God gave his Son. The Bible records that the Lord Jesus Christ left the Holy of Most Holies, left the heavenly bound of glory, and came down on this planet and lived 33 and a half years. 48 prophecies concerning the first advent of the Lord Jesus Christ. He went to Calvary's cross. He knew he was going to Calvary's cross. He knew how he was going to die. He knew that he was going to be beaten. He knew he was going to be mocked. He knew he was going to be spit upon. His beard was going to be pulled. He knew where the nails were going to go. He knew the agony of the crucifixion, and yet he still went to the cross that he may die for you. Because the wages of sin is death. You have a terminal disease called sin, and it causes death. The very fact is that you will die proves you are a sinner. And you cannot say, oh, I'm not going to die. You cannot say, oh, I'm not a sinner. Because both of them are in you. You have been born to die. Christ was born that you may be saved and believe on him. For the Lord Jesus Christ fulfilled what you need to do to be saved. That is to believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved. Not of works. If you can save yourself, then why did he go through the 33 and a half years? Why did he go to the cross if you can do your own salvation? And the very gospel, the gospel of the Bible, states, for Christ died, was buried according to the scriptures. And on the third day he risen, he rose, he came out of that graveyard according to the scriptures. There is nowhere in that gospel for your religion. There is nowhere in that gospel for your works. There is nowhere in that gospel about being agnostic. There is nowhere in that gospel about being an atheist. Your birthday was yesterday. For the fool has said in his heart that there is no God. If you proclaim that you don't believe in God, the Bible has proclaimed to you not once but twice in the Psalms. Psalms 14:1 says you are a fool. And one not ought to die as a fool. Some of you scorn. Ah, listen to that guy. Listen to that loud mouth. Ah, Jesus this, Jesus that. The Bible preaching to those that are lost, or to those that are fools, to those that scorn, and to some of you, you have no idea what to do. The Bible calls you simple, and that's not degrading. I said simple. I didn't say stupid. I didn't say idiot. I didn't say anything like that. Simple is you don't know. The Bible tells us to go ye all the world and preach the gospel, because not many people know what to do. Not many people know what God expects from them. And if you're going to a typical American church today, you have no idea what to when we go to Proverbs chapter 1, Proverbs chapter 1, written by the wisest man of ever, recorded by God, Solomon. In Proverbs chapter 1, try to keep my place with the windy weather. Wisdom crieth without. She utters her voice in the streets. This is exactly what we're doing right here by preaching the gospel on the streets. We are giving you the wisdom to be wise what God wants you to know. Wisdom is how to apply what you know. What you are to know, expected by God, is you're to believe and put your faith and trust in the Lord Jesus Christ. He died for your sins. It's not just good to know that He died for your sins, but you got to be able to apply that knowledge into your life, or you'll be cast off in the sinner's hell thinking, "Oh, I thought I was saved." Comes to salvation. Oh, I know Jesus. I know the cross. But have you applied what you know to your life? We stand here preaching to you, trying to be week after week after week, to show you what God expects from you. Wisdom cries without her. She utters her voice in the streets. That's a street preacher. That's a true preacher of the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. You're not going to go to church tomorrow, so we'll bring the message to you today. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us be glad and rejoice in it that you are hearing the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. You are now given opportunity to hear what God expects from you. She crieth in the chief place of concourse. What's a concourse? Exactly what's going on here. Trading and business, selling and dealing. The Bible has already pre-wrote and go to the farmer's market. Go to the place of businesses and preach wisdom. Preach the wisdom of God that you may hear. Now, all I can do is preach. I can't make you get saved. I can't make you do what God expects from you. You may roll up your windows. You may close your ears. That's your prerogative. That's your choice. My choice is to preach the gospel, and I forewarn you, you better do what God tells you to do. Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved. In the openings of the gates, in the city, she utters her words, saying, wisdom has taken on a person of a preacher who goes out of the church house, who steps out of the pulpit and takes it to the message to the streets. You may not think it. You may not care. But according to the Bible, we stand here in God's wisdom. We are wise in the eyes of God because we bring His word to you. Her message is simple. How long, ye simple ones, will you love simplicity? I spoke about before being simple. Why will you not step out and believe on the Lord Jesus Christ? Why will you put your faith in something that is not? Why will you trust Satan in his lies? Why would you trust in flesh that can't do you no good? I'm telling you to step out from religion. I'm telling you to step out from man behind a pulpit. I'm telling you to step out from church and step into Jesus Christ. It's a simple thing to believe on the Lord Jesus Christ to be saved. And the Bible says, why, how long will you be so simple? Do not die in your simpleness. Step out and be wise in Christ. And the scorners delight in their scorning. We know that the Daytona farmers market is full of scorners. And that ought not to be so, but the Bible already says that's what it is. And you make the Bible true. But step out from your scorning and realize that if we are believing, if we are preaching the truth of God, you are the ones found at fault, not us. And if our message is from God and is true, you will be found wanting before God at the judgment. And you will not be able to pass that judgment without the blood of Jesus Christ, which we preach. And God will name you as a scorner for all eternity into the gates of hell. And you need not. The solution is to believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved. You're going to die. And right now, John chapter 3 says you're not going to hell. You are in hell already if you have not believed on the only begotten Son of God. You need to change your destination. You've gotten, pardon the words of the song, but you've got a highway to hell. You need to take the exit of the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ at Calvary to make it to the highway to heaven. And the wisdom that cries out in Proverbs said there are simple ones, there are scorners, and yet there's one more. And fools hate knowledge. I'm trying to read the Bible in the wind. There are simple people, there are scorners, and there are fools, and I've already told you, their birthday was yesterday. The Bible says in Psalms 14:1, the fool has said in his heart, there is no God. You hear the Daytona farmers market, if you proclaim right now there's no God, the Bible calls you a fool. I don't care what education you got. I don't care how far you went up the education ladder. I don't care where you are at your job and your career. To proclaim to be an atheist is a foolish thing in the Bible. And you need to change. You need to repent. You need to come to God. Well, I don't believe in God. Prepare to meet thy God, the Bible states. You will meet the God that you don't believe, and at that day you'll believe. Let me tell you one thing according to what the Bible says. Graveyards across America, graveyards across the world are Bible believers today. Everyone that has died believes the Bible. Everyone that has died believes in God. Everyone that has died has believed in Jesus Christ, but they didn't do it at the right time. And Jesus told us about a man that's in hell. Turn ye at my reproof. The Bible commands to you to get on your knees. You come over here and we'll show you what the Bible says. We've got booklets, we've got tracts for what you to do. You're to repent of your sins and turn to God through His Son about your sins. You are to put your sins under the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ to be cleansed. Dying in your sins will have you to pay for your sins. Burning in the lake of fire that burns forever. Where you can have your sins paid for and bought at Calvary. Behold, I will pour out my spirit unto you. Stepping out. Come on, if you're thinking about believing in the Lord Jesus Christ, step out. You gotta come out. Come now. And as you come, the Spirit of God will come upon you. And will aid you. The very hardest thing ever is to start anything. Whether it's writing down a book, taking a step, and yet God says, come. Come now, let us reason together. The Bible proclaims, my spirit, God's spirit, will be poured upon you once you come out. I will make known my words unto you. You step out, we'll take a King James 1611 Bible, and we'll proclaim what God has said to you, not man, not anything else, not religion, but what God has prescribed for you. Because I have called, and ye refused. Week after week after week after week, you refuse. Now, we may be preaching to new customers here and there, but listen, new vendors are definitely without excuse as we try to be here week after week. We have called to you to come out and believe on the Lord Jesus Christ. I have stretched out my hand, and no man regardeth. There is no care about God. There is no care about your life. There is no care about the afterthought. There is no care for your soul. Last week, there's no fear. And if you don't have that, if you don't get that, you will die in your sin and you will burn in hell. Because you got to fear God. Fearing God will bring you knowledge. The knowledge that you're a sinner. The knowledge will bring the wisdom that we are preaching to you, that you may know what to do with your sin. But ye have set at naught all my counsel. You're not even listening to what God has to say. And yet, volume-wise, I'm loud. And yet, you're hearing, unconsciously, the words that are being spoken by the Bible, by God, by the Holy Spirit. You don't even have respect for God. As soon as I said we are to open the Bible, commerce should have stopped, heads should have turned, ears would have been attentive to what God has to say. But you set the word of God at naught. And would none of my reproof. You're just outright not listening. Lord willing, because I don't know what's going to happen, I'm not going to quit. I am not going to quit this Bible. I am not going to quit preaching the word, Lord willing. I hope one of you, I hope all of you, but at least one of you, I will hope that you quit being so hard to God. I hope that you will seek the need that you need God in your life and the Lord Jesus Christ to wash away your sins. Verse 26 of Proverbs 1 is a very serious remark by God. A God that's not preaching the pulpits today. to say is not the God of love. He's surely not Santa Claus. And he's not the Easter Bunny, the God I'm going to read about. When you continue to reject what God has offered to you, his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ, the gospel that he died for your sins, was buried according to the scriptures, and arose again on the third day according to the scriptures. When you reject what God has done to you, I also will laugh at your calamity. Proverbs 1:26. That is not my words. Let me tell you, sinner. Let me tell you, heathen. God will get the last laugh. A holy, righteous, almighty laugh at you that turn from the gospel. Told you it wasn't popular. I told you it wasn't your American church God. God loves a sinner. God hates sin and loves a sinner. That's a bunch of crap. Somebody says that doesn't read their Bible. God said, you don't do what wisdom tells you to do, I'm going to laugh at you one day. And we're not done. Proverbs 1, 26 again. I will mock when your fear cometh. You'll fear God, the great white throne judgment, but too late, sorry. You can't push the restart button. You can't go game over, okay, start again. You can't get little bouncy things or balloons for recharge. When you stand at the great white throne judgment of God, it's too late. And God will laugh at you. Because you have laughed at his message. You have laughed at his word. You have laughed at Jesus. You have laughed at his messengers. Proverbs 1:27, make sure you know that this is in the Bible. When your fear cometh as desolation, and your destruction cometh as a whirlwind, when distress and anguish cometh upon you, then shall you call upon me, but I will not answer, God said. You may come in a time of your life by rejecting the Bible, God say, nope, ain't listening to you. You wouldn't listen to my words, why should I listen to you? You want to laugh at my preachers? I'll laugh at you. That's not the Easter Bunny God. That's the holy, almighty God of the Bible saying, he'll get the last laugh. He'll get you. God is not deceived. Whatsoever a man soweth, that he shall also reap. I'm reading from the book of Proverbs, chapter 1, and I'm giving you the verse numbers so you know where I'm reading. Chapter 1, verse 28. They shall seek me early, but they shall not find me. God, the doctor says cancer, get away from me. But God, I've already spoken to you. I've already sent my message to you. I've already tried to plant the seed. I've already tried to cultivate. I tried to water, but you wouldn't listen. How many times did you hear Hark the Herald Angels Sing? How many tomatoes did you buy that Saturday? It's pretty hard to go to hell in America. Yet, the highway's full. Backed up miles and miles of traffic. This may be your last day ever to repent and believe on the Lord Jesus Christ. There may be a warning to one person here that you're not going to survive this afternoon. You won't be here tomorrow. And if you die without Christ, you'll be burning in hell forever. Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved. Why does God say? Proverbs 1:29. For that they hated knowledge and did not choose the fear of God. And I talked about that last week, the fear of God. God will reject you because you have rejected Him and His gospel. Plain and simple. For God so loved the world. Ladies and gentlemen, that love is past tense. The love of God is at Calvary about 33 A.D., somewhere in that time frame. If you choose to walk away from Calvary believing not on Jesus Christ, rejecting Jesus Christ, God does not love you. If you continue to reject the Word, reject Jesus Christ, anybody that tells you that God loves you is a liar from Satan. Because the love of God was shed upon the cross that Jesus died upon. There's the love of God. The way to continue in the love of God is to believe on the Lord Jesus Christ and put your faith and trust in Him and repent of your sins and get right and be a new creature. This laughter, this trying to seek God and won't get Him because you rejected what He told you to do. Chapter 1, verse 30. They want none of my counsel. They despise all my reproof. You just won't listen. You won't adhere to what God says. You don't care. You wish He shut up. You wish He go away. You wish He find another farmer's market. You wish He shut the book. You wish He served hamburgers and beer and dancing music. That's not going to get you saved. Chapter 1, verse 31. Therefore shall they eat the fruit of their own way. Fruit, look at that. And be filled with their own devices. For the turning of the way the simple shall slay them, and the prosperity of the fool shall destroy them. We preach the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ to your welfare. If you reject what God has said for you to do, it's your own destruction. I have been faithful to what the words of God have proclaimed. April 1987, I was faithful to the call of God. What's my calling for God? To believe on the Lord Jesus Christ to be saved. That's the calling of God. There's no other calling out there until you believe on God as your Savior, the Lord Jesus Christ. And don't tell me God loves you when you reject Jesus Christ. Don't tell me God loves you when you say Jesus is not God. Don't tell me you love me, God, when you say Jesus came to North America. Don't tell me you love God when you say I eat His body and blood. Don't tell me you love God. Tell me you love God by receiving Jesus Christ as your Savior. Proverbs 1:32. For the turning away the simple shall slay them, and the prosperity of fools shall destroy them. But whosoever hearkens unto me shall dwell safely of evil. The promise of God is eternal life. God is offering to you eternal life. And eternal life is a free gift. There goes a couple of corners right now. It's a free gift. There's no cash, check, credit cards, no doing good deeds, no church service, no baptism, no affiliations. It's a free gift. The first part, the wages of sin is death. You got to do that part, and you're going to die. You will die. But the verse ain't finished. The wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ, our Lord. For God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in Him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Everlasting life in the Bible is all upon the finished work of Jesus Christ. Nowhere in the Bible does God tell you to get baptized to be saved. Nowhere does God tell you to get involved in the religion to get to heaven. Nowhere does God say, do good works and I'll let you in. Nowhere in the Bible do I see Peter at the pearly gates. My Jesus is the Son of God, and my Jesus is God. My Jesus is the Savior sent by God, the only mediator between God and man, the man Christ Jesus. Some of you today here are simple. Some of you are scorners. Some of you are fools. How dare I say that? I didn't say it, the Bible said it. Some of you might even be saved. Couldn't tell by your actions, but maybe you are saved. But I say 99% of you are lost and going to hell. Come out from simpleness. Come out from scorning. Come out from being foolish. And believe on the Lord Jesus Christ to be saved. Get the love of God by Calvary, by the empty tomb. For God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever, simple, scorners, fools, for whosoever shall call upon His name shall be saved. Simple.